I combined my passions for vintage video games and robotics to build a Nintendo NES combat robot that looks like it belongs in the 80s but packs a modern punch. I used to collect vintage Nintendo, Sega, and Atari game consoles from the 1900s. When I moved my collection on a while back, I kept this pile of Nintendo NES consoles with the idea that I might use them for a project sometime. The consoles have been used and abused, but there are also some signs of past love. This one is the pick of the bunch. Let's call it Deb's NES for now. The Nintendo Entertainment System was huge in the 1980s, and so were robots. Nintendo even made their own robot companion for the NES, and they both made their way into Hollywood and pop culture. So it's only fitting that I pay tribute by creating a NES combat robot. Combat robotics is alive and well in Australia. Competitors spend some serious time and dollars to create these impressive death machines, but my robot will be built for exhibition matches. Four different weight classes are run here, with one of the most popular being the Beatles. Perfect for a NES combat robot. Disassembling the console is straightforward with no special tools required. I pulled out everything that's removable until I was left with just the case that will form the chassis of the robot. I picked up a pair of these brushless gear motors to drive the wheels. And then I shortened the shaft to fit the dimensions of my wheels and chassis. I designed these motor mounts to suit the NES chassis and then 3D printed them using PLA filament. These aluminium wheel hubs have a really neat system for locking the tyres in place so that they don't come loose during battle. It doesn't quite feel right drilling holes in a vintage gaming console, or cutting gaping holes in it, but it was necessary to fit the motors. This will be the weapon motor. I salvaged it from an old drone that I crashed. I grabbed a pulley off an old 3D printer and decided to tap a thread to fit it to the drone motor. It didn't work out so well, and that's when I learned that these pulleys are two parts pressed together. So I grabbed another one, drilled it out to fit the shaft, and just used the grub screws to secure it. I 3D printed the plates and brackets that would form the mount for the weapon motor, and added some hardware to spin the weapon. But I was a little short on space, so I redesigned the parts to use a lower profile motor, also from a drone. And that all worked out well. I found some scrap plate aluminium that I could use to recreate some of the plastic parts from metal. This was far stronger and stiffer. I used springs and a latch mechanism to give the weapon a one-way slide system. Things were heating up in the workshop at this point, so I bought a little AC so that I could keep working. I needed to fit two servos to the robot, this one to actuate the weapon slide, and this one to raise and lower the lid. I used some piano wire to make the linkages for the servos. I started wiring everything up and decided to use Wago terminal blocks to speed things up a bit. These tiny motor speed controllers come pre-programmed to suit the motors, and this larger ESC is taken from my wrecked drone. This is a tiny kill switch that allows me to power the robot on and off safely from the outside. I dismantled this laser pointer, removed the laser unit, and fitted it where the power LED used to be. The electronics were finished, and the battery now has a home. Yeah. After a successful bench test, it was time for a test drive. It was a little too quick, so I dialed it down a bit. All of the parts in this video were printed with the Sovol SV06, which was provided to me by Sovol. It features 25-point auto bed leveling using an inductive sensor, dual Z-axis lead screws and stepper motors, and auto X-axis leveling. I used PLA filament for this project, but the all-metal hot end should handle just about any filament. And the flexible build plate works a treat. It hasn't missed a beat yet, so it's replaced my Ender 3 Pro as my go-to printer. I 3D printed a saw blade and fit it to the pulley. It wasn't particularly sharp, but it showed that the weapon had decent torque. But it was destroying itself quickly, so 3D printing is probably not the answer for a saw blade. I headed down to my local hardware store to grab a snag and a proper blade that would fit the robot. I marked out some holes using a template and then drilled them so that I could attach the blade to my pulley. After fitting that, the robot was complete. I was still below the weight limit, so I decided to add a couple of extra features. First, I had to find a way to refit the controller ports to the console. Then I designed a wedgelet attachment to fit in the ports. Next, I cut a small strip of LEDs and fitted a diffuser, and then attached that to the inside of the console's lid. And now it was time to remove all traces of Deb and Nintendo from the console to give it a new name. This is the startup procedure. Set the weapon slide. Connect main power. Connect LED power. Fit the top of the robot over the blade and servo linkage. Remove the lid hinge retainer. Fit the servo horn to the linkage. Refit the lid hinge retainer. Fasten the two sides of the robot together. Power up the transmitter. Kill switch on. I've started a Patreon where you can support the channel, access exclusive design files, early videos, extra content, and more. The link is in the description. At this point in the video, you may be wondering why I haven't spun the saw blade up yet. Well, it's kinda scary, so I built this box that will offer some protection to my ankles. And now it's time to test, starting with a watermelon. The bot handled that easily. A quick cleanup, and we were ready to tackle one of the greatest games never made. That's not good. The weapon speed controller was shutting down on overload. I think the game won that round. And lastly, Australia's finest beer. no challenge. And the butt is a pulpy, sticky mess with some minor damage. But this was all just training. The next fight will be bot versus bot against the NES's most notorious enemy, the Sega Master System.